Hello friends, this is the presentation on user authentication. Outline of the presentation: remote user authentication principles, remote user authentication using symmetric encryption, Kerberos, remote user authentication using asymmetric encryption. Remote user authentication principles. User authentication is the means to validate the claimed identity to the system. Four general means of authenticating a user's identity: something the individual knows, like password, PIN. PIN stands for personal identification number. Something the individual possesses, like cryptographic keys, electronic key cards, smart cards, and physical keys. Third one is something the individual is static biometrics, like recognition by fingerprint, retina, and face. Fourth one is something the individual does, dynamic biometrics, recognition by voice pattern, handwriting characteristics, and typing rhythm. All of these methods can provide secure user authentication, but each method has some problems. An adversary may be able to guess or steal a password. An adversary may be able to forge or steal a token. A user forget a password or lose a token. Dealing with false positive or false negative, user acceptance, cost, and convenience. Remote user authentication using symmetric encryption. First protocol is Nidham-Schroeder protocol for secret key distribution using a KDC. The user A sends message KDC. This message: first, identity of A, identity of B, and nonce N1. KDC send back the message to A. This is secret key of A, session key, identity of B, nonce N1. And this message is encrypted with the secret key of E, and the session key and identity of A is encrypted with the secret key of user B. The A sends the message to B, the session key and identity of A encrypted with the secret key of B, and B sends the A the nonce N2 created by the user B, encrypted with the one-time session key, and A sends back to B the transformation of nonce N2 encrypted with the one-time session key. And this scheme is vulnerable to a form of ripple attack. So the Denning proposes to overcome this weakness. The user A sends KDC ID of A and ID of B. KDC return back a message to A, that is session key, identity of B, and a timestamp T encrypted with the secret key of A. And another message concatenated is session key, identity of A, timestamp T, and encrypted with the secret key of B. A sends B the session key, identity of A, and timestamp encrypted with the secret key of B. B sends A the nonce N1 encrypted with the session key. A sends B the transformation of nonce N1 encrypted with the session key, where T is the timestamp. Timestamp T assures A and B that the session key distribution is a fresh exchange. A and B can verify timeliness by checking that clock minus T is less than delta T1 plus delta T2. Well, delta T1 is the estimate normal discrepancy between the KDC's clock and the local clock at A or B, and delta 2 is the expected network delay time. Kerberos, an authentication service developed at MIT. provides centralized private key third party authentication in a distributed network, allows user access to services distributed through network without needing to trust all workstations, rather all trust central authentication servers. Two versions are in use, 4 and 5. Kerberos requirements: secure, be strong enough that a potential opponent does not find it to be the weak link. It reliable, it should be highly reliable and one system able to back up another system. Transparent, the user should not be aware that authentication is taking place beyond the requirement to enter a password. Scalable, capable of supporting large number of clients and servers. Kerberos version 4 overview: a basic third-party authentication scheme. Have an authenticate server AS. Users initially negotiate with AS to identify itself. AS provides a non-corruptible authentication credential. Ticket granting ticket TGT. Have a ticket granting server TGS. Users subsequently request access to other services from TGS on basis of users TGT. Kerberos version 4 dialog: obtain ticket granting ticket from authenticate servers one per session. Obtain service granting ticket from TGT for each distinct service required. Client server extends to obtain service on every service request. And this is the diagram of Kerberos 4 overview. Here is, we say that the Kerberos and is the Kerberos consists of authenticate server, a ticket granting service, and this is the client request ticket granting ticket, then ticket plus session key, then request service granting ticket, ticket plus session key, and then request to server, provide server authenticator. Kerberos RealMS. A Kerberos environment consists of a Kerberos server, a number of clients all registered with server, application server sharing keys with server. This is termed as RealM, typically a single administrative domain. If you have multiple RealMs, their Kerberos server must share keys and trust. Kerberos RealMs. E. Kerberos authenticate server, ticket granting servers. This is the client. And this is another Kerberos, this ZLM B, and this authentication server and ticket granting server, and this is the server client. Kerberos version 5, developed in mid 1990s, specified as internet standard RFC 1510, provides improvement over version 4, addresses environment shortcomings. Encryption algorithm, network protocol, byte order, ticket, lifetime authentication, forwarding, inter-realm authentication, and technical deficiencies are double encryption, non-standard mode of use, session keys, password attacks. Remote user authentication using asymmetric encryption. First of all, mutual authentication protocol consists of the following steps. The user sends KDC, ID of A, ID of B, KDC sends A, the ID of B and public key of B encrypted with the private key of the KDC authenticator, and this is the public key certificate. And A sends B, the nonce of A and ID of A encrypted with the public key of B. And B sends KDC, the ID of A, ID of B, and the nonce A encrypted with the public key of KDC. KDC sends back to B the ID of A, public key of A, and this is encrypted with the private key of KDC and public and private key of this nonce of A, session key, and ID of B encrypted with the private key of KDC, and this whole is encrypted with, and this is encrypted with the public key of B. This sends A the public, the encrypted message of नॉन्स ए सेशन की, आइडेंटिटी ऑफ बी, नॉन्स बी इनक्रिप्टेड विद द प्राइवेट की ऑफ द ऑथेंटिकेटर, एंड दिस होल इज एनक्रिप्टेड विद द पब्लिक की ऑफ ए, एंड ए सेंड्स बी द नॉन्स बी एनक्रिप्टेड विद द सेशन की. वन वे ऑथेंटिकेशन इफ कॉन्फिडेंशली इज द प्राइमरी कंसर्न, देन द मैसेज यूजर ए सेंड्स टू बी द सेशन की एनक्रिप्टेड विद द पब्लिक की ऑफ बी, एंड द यूजर बी डिक्रिप्ट द सेशन की विद इट्स प्राइवेट की, एंड दे यूज दैट सेशन की टू डिक्रिप्ट द मैसेज एम. इफ ऑथेंटिकेशन इज द प्राइमरी कंसर्न, देन यूजर ए सेंड्स टू बी द मैसेज कॉन्क्रिप्टेड विद द हैश कोड ऑफ द मैसेज एनक्रिप्टेड विद द प्राइवेट की ऑफ ए, एंड देन यूजर बी कंप्यूट द हैश कोड विद द मैसेज एम एंड डिक्रिप्ट द हैश कोड वैल्यू विद द पब्लिक की ऑफ यूजर ए एंड कंपेयर देम. थैंक यू.